Hello everyone, in this presentation we'll construct the tangents issued from the external point A to the given circle C of center I. This construction is done by many steps. Let's start by step number 1. Determine the midpoint of the line segment AI. Step number 2. Draw a circle of diameter AI. Offshore, the midpoint of the line segment AI is the center of the new circle. Step number 3, mark and name M and N, the points of intersection between the original circle C and a new circle. Step number 4, join IM and IN. Step number 5, join the lines AM and AN. By construction, AM and AN are two tangents issued from the external point A to the circle C. But we have not finished yet. To show that AM is the tangent, we should show that the angle AMI measures 90 degrees. What is the measure of the angle AMI? Look at the figure. AMI is an inscribed angle in a new circle facing diameter IA. This is why AMI measures 90 degrees. Consequently, AM is tangent to C. Similarly for AN. The angle ANI is an inscribed angle in a new circle facing diameter AI. So the measure of ANI is 90 degrees also. Since these two angles are right angle, consequently AM and AN are two tangents. Now, I will change by the position of A and observe by your own what is happening in the figure. Let's change by the position of A. What do you observe? As A gets closer and closer to the circle C, we still have two tangents. Now, observe if A is far from the center of the circle C. If A is far from I. If A is far from the center I, we still have two tangents. Offshore, in this case, the size of a new circle, as shown, will increase. If A is closer and closer to the center of the circle, the size of a circle will decrease. But in all cases, as you see in the figure, whenever I change the position of A, we still have two tangents to the circle C. And the construction of these two tangents are done by these steps. Thanks for your listening.